This is Ampest 124, and guys, today we're reading Job 28 from the New International Version, also known as NIV Version. If you guys want to read along, you guys can go to classicbiblegeekyear.com, or you guys can go ahead and go get your Bible. I don't really care how you guys end up, but let's get started. Job 28, New International Version, NIV, interlude where wisdom is found. There is a mine for silver, and a place where gold is refined. Iron is taken from the earth, and copper is smelted from ore. Mortals put an end to the dark, and I say, search out the farthest recesses for ore in the blackest darkness. Far from human dwellings, they cut a shaft in places untouched by human feet. Far from other people, they dangle and sway. The earth from which food comes is transformed below as by fire. Lapis lazuli comes from its rocks, and its dust contains nuggets of gold. No bird of prey knows that hidden path. No falcon's eye has seen it. Proud beasts do not set foot on it, and no lion prowls there. People assault the flinty rock with their hands, and lay bare the roots of the mountains. They tunnel through the rock, their eyes see all its treasures. They search the sources of the rivers and bring hidden things to light. But where can wisdom be found? Where does understanding dwell? No mortal comprehends its worth. It cannot be found in the land of the living. The deep says it is not in me. The sea says it is not in me. It cannot be bought with the finest gold, nor can its price be weighed on silver. It cannot be bought with the gold of Ophir, with precious onyx or lapis lazuli. Neither gold nor crystal can compare with it, nor can it be had for jewels of gold. Coral and jasper are not worthy of mention. The price of wisdom is beyond rubies. The topaz of Kush cannot compare with it. It cannot be bought with pure gold. Where then does wisdom come from? Where does understanding dwell? It is hidden from the eyes of every living thing, concealed even from the birds in the sky. Destruction and death say, only a rumor of it has reached our ears. God understands the way to it, and he alone knows where it dwells. For he views the ends of the earth and sees everything under the heavens. When he established the forces of the wind and measured out the waters. When he made a decree for the rain and a path for the thunderstorm. Then he looked at wisdom and appraised it. He confirmed it and tested it. And he says to the human race to fear the Lord, that is wisdom, and to shun evil is understanding. Okay, guys, I really hope that you guys enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe, make sure to click that like button, make sure to click the button to be notified when I post. I really hope that you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.